हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर विकास गोयल वंस अगेन विद द अनदर टॉपिक ऑफ रियल टाइम ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द रियल टाइम कम्युनिकेशंस। दीज आर माय कंटेंट्स ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर। फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन रियल टाइम कम्युनिकेशन, देन वी डिस्कस the model of the real time communication, then what are the different parameters which are used to define the quality of service, then the throughput, delay and the jitters, and at last we will discuss the what are the various real time connections and the service disciplines. So first of all, what do you understand by the real time communication? So real time communication is a methodology, or it is a method by which a device is communicated to the another device in a real-time system without any delay. As such, we have already discussed in case of real-time system that there should not be any delay. So that concept we will use in the real-time communication. So in a real-time communication applications, the data is sent from one source to another destination through a directed path. And we can now discuss the various examples of the real-time communications. For example, emailing and chatting. So as you can see, there is a big difference between a emailing and a chatting. Email is more or less, it is a time-shifting form of communication. You send a mail at that particular time, and after a certain amount of time, the mail is delivered to the another person. Might be that person will see that email right now or maybe later. So that is a time shift of communication. Whereas in case of chatting, we expect the response just as we are communicating face to face in real time. If two persons are communicating to each other, if one person is saying something, then the another will respond in a real time. So we expect that kind of communication in case of chatting. Now the other examples are like the video conferencing, in which there is a live, we can say the video conferencing is going on, the gaming, file sharing, screen sharing, collaboration tools, machine to machine technology, location tracking, online education, social networking. So in all the applications, we can say there is a movement of real time data. Now, this is the, we can say, the overall architecture in case of real-time communication. And in this communication, there are two devices. One is this and the another one is this. And on these devices, we have the various, these are the applications. So, these are the applications. So, what basically a particular this application wants to communicate to the other device applications. Okay, and these are the applications. So that's why we are saying applications. This is the transport layer, and in between there is a network layer, network interface, and this is the, we can say, the physical layer on which actually the data is flowing or data is communicating from one node to the another node. So actually how the communication is taken place in this particular model. So say for example, this particular application wants to communicate to this particular application on the another node. So this application will send a message to the TPH. Now what is the TPH? TPH is the transport control handler, which is an interface between the application and the transport layer. So it takes the message and put it into the that queue in which all the messages are put. So basically on the transport layer, we are maintaining two types of the queue. This is the outgoing queue and this is the incoming queue. So when this application wants to communicate to this particular application, this application will send the message to this particular queue through the TPH. Now the NACH, that is a network access control handler, will pass this message on the top of the queue to the network interface, and through the communication network, that message is again received by this network interface. And now with the help of the network access control handler, we will put that message in the incoming queue. And in the incoming queue, when the terms come, the TPH, again the transport protocol handler, will transport this message to this particular application. So this is how the communication is going on between the two devices or two applications. Now, need of the modal source of the latency. So queue delay is there, network transmit time, the network transmit time from this particular to over here, and the queue delay over here. So there are three types of the latency over here. One latency is over here, that is the sender queue delay at the sender, then the transmit time, and the another one is the queue delay at the receiver side. So this is all about, we can say, the overall architecture of the communication model. So the real time communication model depicts the message exchange among the applications on different hosts. The source and the destination of messages are the application on the different host, and the two local servers are taken place. The transport protocol handler TPH and the network access control handler NACH. The transport protocol handler TPH is an interface between the application and provides them to message transport services, whereas the NACH with the network below provides the network access and the message transmission services to the above, that is the TP handler. When request to send message by a local application task, the source TPH places the message in the output queue, that we have already discussed a lot in the message communication. Now, what are the various, we can say, the terms which are used to define the quality of service in case of real-time communication system? So those are, how will you define the packet, how will you define the network bandwidth, and what is the physical size? So all the messages are fragmented into the small segments for the transmission, and each segment is handled by the basic transmission unit. And these units or these segments or the basic transmission unit is called a frame or a packet or a cell. It depends on what layer we are discussing that segment, or in what kind of network we are discussing that basic transmission unit. For example, a packet. So a packet is a 53 byte cell in an ATM network, because in case of ATM networks, we are considering the cell. Whereas in case of token ring, a frame of tens of kilobyte in IEEE 802.5, that is the token ring. So in case of ATM network, we are considering the cell of this particular size. In case of token ring, we are considering the frame of that particular size. Now, based on that particular size, the length of the time required to transmit a maximum length, and the packet over data link is the basic time unit. Examples: the time required to transmit a 53 byte packets over 100 megahertz link, that is a bandwidth, is 4.24 millisecond. So the length of each message by the number of packets will be equals to, a message of length 100 has 100 into 53, that is 5.3 kilobytes. Now, what are the various types of the traffic which we are going to consider in a real-time model? So, we are considering the two types of the messages, the periodic message and the sporadic messages. Whereas we are saying the traffic consists of the message streams generated by the source on a continuous basis and delivered to the destination on a continuous basis. Now, what are the periodic and the sporadic messages? Already we have discussed a lot, but once again, We are saying the periodic messages are the streams carrying the sensor data and the actuator command generated by the digital controller. And another example is like the video, in case of video, voice and video. So constant bitrate digitized data is used. For example, in case of periodic message M, that M is depicted by a tuple which is PI, EI and DI, where PI is the period of message, EI is the maximum packet length of the instances that we called as the execution time, and DI is the maximum time duration of delivering the each instances. This traffic model is called the peak rate model in case of real-time communication model, and many times we are considering this particular model in which we are taking the periodic message. Same as we can say the sporadic messages, but we are not going to consider the sporadic messages. But a periodic message is an inaccurate model of any sporadic message stream, that sometimes threshold miss rate is never exceeded. Now, what are the various terms in order to define the quality of service? That is the throughput, delay and the jitter. Now, what is the throughput? Throughput is the measure of the numbers of packets or message stream that the network can deliver per unit time. So in a per unit time, how or how many number of packets you are delivering, that is the throughput. The delay, which is called as the latency, is the time taken to deliver the packet or the message stream. Likewise, in case of the model, we have discussed the three kind of delay or the latency. One is the outgoing queue at the sender, another is the transmission link, and the third one is the receiver link queue. So we are going to consider how much delay is there. So it is a fixed due to minimum propagation delay due to span of light and varying due to a queuing on path. How much time you are spending in the queue, or how much time do you need for propagation of a message. And the another term which is related to the delay is the jitter. So the term indicated variance on delay. So what is the jitter? It is a variance on delay. So many real-time communication protocol and algorithms are designed to keep not only the worst case delay and jitter as small as they can. Now, what are the various real-time connections and services disciplines? So the connection-oriented approach is used for real-time traffic, always and always. So like we are saying, in case of network, there are two approach. One is the connection oriented and the another one is the connectionless. So in case of connection oriented, there is a dedicated path between the sender and the receiver. In case of connectionless, there is no dedicated path. You have the message, just you are going to transfer the message. So we are considering the connection oriented approach. So according to this approach, a simplex logical connection. Now, again, we are saying the connection is of three type: the simplex, the hub, duplex and the full duplex. So over here, we are just considering the simplex. So in this particular approach, a simplex logical connection is set up for transmission of each message stream between source and a destination. A fixed routing is used. So first of all, the connection, and the another thing is the routing. So a fixed routing is used to route the packets, and chosen route is fixed until all the messages are transferred from source to the destination. And whenever a new connection is established, if the existing network meets the quality of service parameter like end-to-end delay, jitter and etc., fine, otherwise we will change the connection. Generally, packet switching network is preferred for transmission of message delay because all the properties are related to the packet switching network. So over here we will consider the packet switch network. As I am going to remind you, there are three types of the network: the packet switching, the circuit switching and the message switching. So over here we are using the packet switching network. So this is the case for the switch, we can say. So this is a diagram for the switch. This is the input queue buffer, or this is the output queue, and these are the input switches. These are the output switches. So the 1 is to link to 3 and 3 is linked to 4 and 4 is linked to 2 and 2 is linked to 1. This is a temporary link. Maybe for the another connection 1 is linked to 2. So that is, we can say, the packet switching network along with the multi-hop switch. For multi-hop switch network and the circle for the network represent a switch. So switches are buffered. That is, there is a buffer pool for each output links holding the packets that are queued for transmission on the link. Once the switch route the packet to the queue, the packet waits in the queue until the scheduler schedules it for transmission. So first of all, the switch buffer will take place, and then the scheduler will schedule the packet for the transmission. The amount of time the switch takes to the route the packet is very small, but the time a packet takes passing through a switch is equal to its output time at the output queue plus the packet transmission time, and this is called a hop delay of the packet. So generally we will say that, okay, that destination is how many hop. So now we are saying it is 2 hop distance, it is a 3 hop distance. So what is a hop? Hop is a time for a switch equals to its output time at the output queue plus the packet transmission time. So the end to end delay of each packet through a switch network is equal to the sum of per hop's delay it suffers passing through all switches in the route plus the total time it takes to propagate along all links between the switches. So when we are saying, okay, there is a message that should be transferred from this particular host to this particular host, so how many switches are in between? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the time required for the hops, so likewise we are saying it is 5 hops if we are considering one hop for a one switch. So these yellows are the switches. So now we are saying that particular, so 5 hops plus the transmission time. So this is the transmission time between host to this particular switch. Now this particular time, transmission time between these switches. So the overall time is the switch time plus the total time it takes to propagate along all the links between the switches. The combination of acceptance test and admission control protocol, a synchronization protocol, and a scheduling algorithm used for the purpose of rate control jitter and scheduling the packet transmission is called a service discipline. So what is the service discipline? It is the, we are going to control the jitter, that is the variance in the delay, and now we have considered the delay. And the another thing is the scheduling the packet transmission. So these two will give you a service discipline. So service discipline are divided into two categories as rate allocating and rate controlled. Rate allocating is for scheduling and rate control is for jitter. So rate allocating discipline allows the packet on each connection to be transmitted at higher rates than guaranteed rates. That's all for the today's lecture. So in this particular lecture we have discussed the various terms related to real-time communication. In the next lecture we will discuss the various terms related to the service disciplines. Thank you.